CM 365, all about Carnatic music.
We all know that Carnatic music has been open always to adaptations at various fronts. And one of them, of course, is the adaptation and adaptation of the Western instruments to suit our Carnatic music. When I say this, you will immediately think about the violin. But today I'm going to talk to you about another instrument, a very significant one, I would say. That is the saxophone, which basically, being a Western instrument, was adapted so beautifully into our system and reached an international status also. Yes, here I must make a mention of the one and only Kadrishi Gopalnath, who brought a unique status to this instrument, and he also lent a special color to Carnatic music through his impeccable play. Now, I also fondly remember the wonderful concerts he played for Mudra for so many years, accompanied by Kanyakumari Amma. In fact, the duo's combo lasted for almost 25 years, I understand, from 1994 to 2019, when he passed away. Yes, but how did this inspiration come about to him, and what did he really do in terms of contributing by adopting this instrument? The first thing, of course, is that at the age of 15, I understand he had a great fancy for this instrument, and his father, seeing his interest in the sax, bought him one from the Polish band for rupees 800 in 1965. Definitely a very pricey amount in those days. After that, we see that the Maharaja Krishnaraja Vodiyar, a Carnatic musician, was also interested in Western instruments. We all know that he lived around Mangalore. So the Maharaja Krishnaraja Vodiyar, a Carnatic musician, was there at that time, and he was also very much interested in Western instruments. And they also had a band called Nadamuni Band, which used to play Carnatic Kritis. Now, if you look at what Shri Kadriji did to the sax, it's a very, very interesting story. The saxophone, basically, we all know, produced staccato notes, and that is what is required in Western music, and it also had a very wide range of about 3.5 octaves. With experimentation, Shri Kadri understood that the Western construction will not be of use to play the kind of gamaka oriented music that ours is. So he needed to really modify the instrument. And also he knew that, all of us in fact know that, our music basically operates around 2 octaves, and we do not require 3.5 octaves to for the music actually. So that also was there in his mind when he was trying to see what kind of modifications he could do. So the modification done to produce gamakas and remove superfluous attachment for enhanced range was the first thing in his mind. Thus, what did he do? Some opening, facilitating, attaining mandra and anumandra blocked, as they were not needed, and the levers operating them were posing to be a hindrance to the fingering, and so he removed that also. The rigid metallic connecting rods operating keys replaced by elastic rubber strings. In fact, he mentioned about this also in one of the interviews I did with him for our Samudra magazine, about how these rubber strings helped in the smooth operation of gamakas. Then of course, leather pads at the bottom of keys, which open and close the holes, were replaced with felt pads. And basically the pitch in which he played was the B flat range. And he also made a mention about, in the same interview I recall, about how it was difficult, yet in spite of the modifications he made, to play certain ragas on the saxophone. Especially he made a mention about the Pratimadhyama ragas, which posed a lot of difficulty in terms of playing. So probably if you look at his concerts, you can also observe about how the Shuddha Madhyama ragas occupied a major portion of all the concerts, the items. Probably this was the reason, because of the difficulty that the instrument posed in terms of playing such Pratimadhyama ragas and certain other notes also. But yet we see that in spite of all this, a remarkable contribution has been made by Kadri Gopalnath, where he traveled globally. I think almost every country in the globe, here in the world, he would have traveled and played concerts, and he made such a great impression on the audience. The second important thing which comes to me is that through his very entertaining way of playing, he brought the masses also into the fold of Carnatic music, and that is a very great contribution, I think, where bringing more people into the fold of music and making them more interested is itself a big contribution to the music, because you are developing a larger spectrum of people for the art itself. So that way, at this juncture, I recall with great respect and reverence the monumental contribution made by Shri Kadri Gopalnath in terms of giving a unique status to the saxophone by adapting it so beautifully into Carnatic music and reaching it to so many, many rasikas all over the globe.
CM 365, all about Carnatic music.